another session of KAPP's ACCA. This is the first session of ACCA F3, and let's try to understand what this subject is all about, and also we shall try to understand the chapter number 1, which is context of financial reporting. ACCA F3, also known as financial accounting subject, is a base for your accounting. This subject will create the further base for the subject F7 and P2 respectively ahead. So it is important for us to understand those basic concepts of accounting quite in detail and very nicely, so that by the time we reach to the next level of F7 and P2, we should be really, really thorough with our concepts. So this particular chapter will talk about the basics of accounting, as to what is financial accounting. We have already discussed in F2 what is management accounting. In F1 and F3, we basically talk about more about financial accounting. So financial accounting, or commonly known as accounting, is something which includes a lot of things related to general entries, making ledgers, trial balance and so on. But more or less, not just the basic of accounting will be covered in ACCA F3, but will also cover quite a lot in detail about international accounting standards. So every country has their own accounting standards. Internationally, we can call them IAS, International Accounting Standard. And other than that, every country has their own respective accounting standards. And on top of it, there is something called IFRS, which is International Financial Reporting Standard. So in this particular subject, we'll have a flair of different IAS and little bit about IFRS. As and when we'll proceed with this subject further in the stages ahead, when it comes to F7, P2 and on those kind of subjects, we shall talk more about financial accounting, IFRS and IAS. So let's start our journey of accounting with the basics of accounting, and the first class is, the first chapter of this particular subject is called context of financial reporting. Before we get into finance, let's try to understand a basic how companies are being formed. So let's talk about different structures of entity. An entity can have a different kind of structure, which may include sole tradership, partnership and the corporates. So let's talk about those entities now. An entity can be formed into various ways. The first could be sole trader. The second could be partnership. Third could be the corporate, or we also call them corporation. Sole tradership is the most basic form of making a business. So as per constitution of the business, when we talk about sole tradership, there is no difference between the business and the owner. They are considered as one of the same. That is where the liability of owner is unlimited. Anything goes wrong with the company will go wrong with the trader, and vice versa. Because here the business and the owners are considered to be one of the same. So as long as the business is small, and when we start the business in the beginning, sole tradership can be a good form to start the business, because it does not have too many regulations. You can make the sole tradership very quickly. There are not much of legal hassles involved. At the same time, the biggest problem with the sole tradership is, one, that the liability of owner is unlimited, and secondly, when your business grows, it makes bigger. In that case, sole tradership may not be one of the best way to do the business. So that's where sole tradership comes into picture. The second form of the business is called partnership. What is partnership? When two or more people join hands to do the business together, we call them partnership. The partnership can be in any ratio. Not necessarily it has to be 50-50. It can be 60-40, could be 99-1 also. So a partnership is a form of business where partners come together to do the business and to share the profits and losses of the business in certain proportion. And this is called partnership. So the relationship of partners are defined by the agreement. We call that partnership deed. The partnership deed includes all the details of partnership, include name of partners, the name of the firm, the nature of the business, the profit sharing ratio, and so on. Again, the advantages wise, partnership is an easy and quick way to make. Unlike corporates, where there are a lot of regulatory requirements and legal hassles, partnership is an easy way to start the business. At the same time, when the number of partners go up and the business expands, probably partnership may not be one of the best way to do it. The other problem with partnership is that if one partner dies or leaves the business, the existing partnership will be dissolved and the new partnership will come into picture. So that is another problem. And again, the liability in partnership is also unlimited. So that is the all about partnership. These days, there are two newer ways to do the partnership. We call them LLP and LLC. LLP and LLC are relatively newer form of partnerships, limited liability partnership and limited liability corporate. As the name suggests, the limited liability partnership is a partnership where the liability of partners are limited, whereas LLC is a mid-form between partnership and the corporate. And the business is neither coming in a traditional partnership nor into corporate. A midway is called LLC, Limited Liability Corporate. So these are, could be a relatively newer form of partnership. Then we move to the third form called corporate. Corporate or a company form. This is most suited when the business expands, when the number of partners goes up. In that case, we generally go ahead and form a company and it's called corporate. So companies can be of two types. We can classify them as private limited and public limited. The LTD word stands for limited. Generally, you might have seen the word PVT, LTD. This stands for private limited. And in public company, only LTD word is used, not PVT. Now let's see what is the difference between private company and a public company. Generally, people think that public company means any company where government has a share. No, that's a misconception. Any company which can issue their share to the public is a public company. Any company which prohibits or which cannot issue the shares to the normal public, it's a private limited company. Whenever private limited company wants to go public, they have to issue the share to the normal public through stock exchanges, and that's called the company is going public. That means there's a difference between private limited company and a public company. All right. Now, when a business expands, the corporate can be one of the best way to start the business. Certain feature of corporate, the owner and the business, these are two different things. So in a company form, we do not consider the owner and business as one of the same. Both are separate. The company is an artificial entity which is represented by its common seal. There may be people called director who runs the business, but again, we consider the owner and the company as two different things, and company is always an artificial entity. So that's the form of company, and in company, since the owner and the companies are two separate people, the liability of directors will be limited. Unlike sole tradership and partnership, where the liabilities were limited, unlimited, in the corporate form, it is limited to the number of shares what you held in the company. So these are about different forms of entity. A company can be formed as sole tradership, partnership, or it could be formed as a corporate. Whatever is the form of making a company, end of the day, company needs to think what form of entity suits their requirement. That entirely depends on the nature of the company, the operations, how big or small it is. So these could be some of the deciding factor, basis which a company decides as to which is the best form to do the business. Now we have understood the company can be formed in various forms. Now let's talk about more, little bit about accounting and bookkeeping. So let's move to the next level and understand these concepts. When we talk about the accounting, generally people use the word bookkeeping and accounting as one of the same. But let me tell you the difference between accounting and bookkeeping. Bookkeeping is a very small concept as compared to accounting. Accounting is much broader content than the bookkeeping. So bookkeeping means recording of transaction, whereas accounting includes the recording, the classification, or we call that classifying, summarizing, and analyzing. So that means the accounting is much broader concept than the bookkeeping. The bookkeeping only includes the first element called recording. Whenever you record any transaction in the books, we call that bookkeeping or recording. The accounting includes recording, which we do through journal entry. Then we classify through ledger account. We summarize, making a final account. And finally, we analyze and interpret through ratio analysis. So if I said that your complete F3 syllabus is covered under these four points, I wouldn't be wrong. We shall learn how to make a journal entry. Then we'll learn how to make a T account or a ledger account. Then we'll learn how to make final account. And finally, we'll talk about ratio analysis. So that's how accounting is covered. So accounting is much broader concept than bookkeeping. Bookkeeping is just a small part of accounting. So that's a core difference between accounting and bookkeeping. Now it is also important for us to understand that the accounting only includes those elements which can be converted into monetary terms. Anything which cannot be converted into monetary term has no place in accounting, such as customer satisfaction, employee satisfaction. These are non-monetary things. Anything which is non-monetary wouldn't have place in accounting. So that's the difference between bookkeeping and accounting. Now we have understand what kind of form of businesses we can have, then we understood the difference between bookkeeping and accounting. Now let's try and understand one more important element called the difference between stockholder and stakeholders. Whenever we do accounting or we make financial statements, we generally use the word that we are making it for stockholder. That's a misconception. Stockholder are also known as investors or shareholder. So please note that stockholder, shareholder and investor is one of the same term. Whereas stakeholder is much broader concept than stockholder. Stakeholder means anybody who has a direct or indirect interest in the business, we call them stakeholder. Let's see what kind of stakeholders we can have. The stakeholders can be classified into three major categories. We call them internal, we call them connected, and finally, we call them external. So there are three major categories of stakeholder. Stakeholder means anyone who has a direct or indirect interest in the business. We call them stakeholders. The internal stakeholder may include employees. It may include management. When we talk about connected, these are people who are outside the business but connected to the business in certain manner. One of the important connected is stockholder. Stockholder is an external party but definitely connected to the business. Then it includes customers, vendors or suppliers, bankers and so on. These are people who are outside the business but definitely are interested in the business and connected to them. External stakeholders are those who are absolutely outside the business, such as government, such as environment, Now that's called external stakeholder. So when we make funnel account, or when we say who are we making financial statement for, then we are making financial statement for stakeholders, not stockholders. Stockholder is just one of the party. So next time when we say who are we making financial statement for, or why are we doing accounting for, we are doing it for stakeholders. Correct? So that is all about this small chapter called context of financial reporting. What we have understood in this chapter, first we understood that how do we start the business. So we can start the business as sole tradership, partnership or a corporate. Then we understood what is the difference between bookkeeping and accounting. And finally, we understood the meaning of stockholder and stakeholder. This is a small chapter which creates the base of our subject called financial accounting. So that's all about this chapter, and let's meet up once again with a new topic. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much.